Today I'm going to show you how to do a post-process effect in Unreal Engine 4, which is called gradient mapping. Well, gradient mapping allows us to take the original image and replace all the values with colors from the given gradient. So it's not for slight color correction. You better use lookup tables for this, or the built-in post-process volume sliders. Gradient mapping is for a total color replacement, so for heavily stylized work. As you can see, the values get mapped to colors on the gradient. We will be doing a specific version of gradient mapping, which allows us to have two color palettes at once. The more yellow the color, the more it will tend towards the upper parts of the gradient. So let's import the gradient. I made it in 32-bit mode. It can be also 16-bit mode. Remember to set clamp here, it will be important in the later stage. RGB curve of 0.45 says that this is an sRGB file, not a linear file. Now I'm going to make the scene as grayscale as possible. It's not a problem to use colors with this technique. Normal textures, normal shaders, but it will be much easier to control when we have everything in grayscale. Fortunately, there are sliders for everything in the default skybox, so it's not a problem to tweak it. I will change the mobility of the skylight to movable, so everything is adjusted in real time. I create a spotlight. The spotlight will be yellow. So as you remember from the beginning of the movie, everything which is affected by the yellow color will tend to use the upper palette from the gradient. And everything grayscale will use the lower palette from the gradient. Let's play with intensities to get it right. Okay, this is how it looks like. To use a post-processing shader, I create a post-process volume. I check unbound, so its effect is visible everywhere, not just inside the box. I want to turn off the auto exposure function, so I set the same value to minimum brightness and maximum brightness. It won't adapt to intensity of the visible part of the scene. Let's tweak ambient occlusion, just for artistic effect. I added a second bump, and this is how the scene looked like at the moment. Obviously, there is no gradient mapping right now. This is just a scene with yellow lamps put inside. But this is what our shader will get as an input. A post-processing shader is just a regular material. It's like your typical material you use to apply textures to objects. The only thing you need to change is material domain inside the material. So set the material domain to post-process. And that's it. Now it's compatible with post-process volume. And the scene texture node, with scene texture ID post-process input 0, just gives us the contents of the scene. So This is what the camera sees. Anything we want to be rendered with the shader has to be put inside the emissive color slot. So here, for example, we have a flat magenta being rendered. Please remember to set aftertone mapping here. Let's try to multiply scene texture with magenta to test the shader. And it says arithmetic between types float 4 and float 3 are undefined. So it's another way of saying that the shader expects alpha channel. Let's append an empty alpha channel of 1. Now we created float 4. Everything is fine. Let's change the color to green. Yeah, it works fine. So now let's create the real shader, the gradient mapping shader. I added a texture sample node which contains our gradient. And break out float 4 components. It just splits the color from the scene texture into separate channels. We will control the gradient using the R value for now. It is temporary, but will be fine for now. And the Y value will be constant, 0.1. Let's see how it looks like. There is a slight problem. It should be after tone mapping, not before tone mapping. As you can see, it works somehow. The more intense the red value is, the more toward the right side of the gradient it goes. But let's obtain the grayscale value with a better method called luminance. There is a trick for that. You can just use a dot product with the number you can see here. Please use exactly the same number you can see. We need a vector 3, not vector 4. Alpha isn't needed. And for the Y value, the Y axis, we will use a constant 0.1. This is our shader for now. It does what you can see on the screen. And it's the most basic kind of gradient mapping, the most popular kind. If we change the Y value, it uses the different part of the gradient. So this is the whole shader for now, how it looks at the moment. And now we will make the use of the yellow color. So what I do here is adding red channel plus green channel. It gives us yellow, and then I subtract 2 times the blue channel from the sum of R and G, so what I end up with is a mask of everything yellow, with gray values being black and yellow values being white. There is a problem because I forgot to set clamp in the tiling. It should be always set to clamp in the gradient texture, and now it looks fine. The yellow colors under the spotlight use the higher values from the gradient. I mean the upper colors. As you can see, as I move the lamp, everything gets properly shaded, replaced. If the scene is too dark, we can either change the gradient or just change the exposure bias in the post-process volume. Yeah, let's take a look around. So this is the full version of the shader. There is the whole yellow color mask in the bottom. We can easily replace the gradient with anything we want. Set clamp. And use it. Some adjustments will be necessary, especially the RGB curve to 0.45 or 0.5. It can be whatever you want, but the value gives you as RGB. With only a few clicks, we replace the colors of the scene using just a different gradient. In the description of the video, you can find links to the textures I used here, the gradients, and the screenshot of the final shader. Also an optimized version. Thank you, and good luck with your projects.